This is a look at some of the best Iron Age hill forts and settlements that remain across Britain. Starting from Cornwall, inland from Penzance is one of the best preserved Iron Age villages in England. It was inhabited from 100 BC to the 3rd century AD. The village was probably created by a local Cornish tribe. 8 courtyard houses have been found, laid out in 2 rows of 4. Remains of a further stone house and huts lie in surrounding fields on the sloping site. This is Castle Andenus, at the summit of Castle Downs near St. Columb Major, still in Cornwall. It is considered one of the most important hill forts in the southwest of Britain. It dates from around the 3rd to the 2nd century BC and consists of 3 ditch and rampart concentric rings, lying at 850 feet above sea level. During the early 1960s, it was excavated by a team led by Dr. Bernard Wallace of the University of Pennsylvania during 2 seasons of excavation. The most famous hill fort in Britain is that of Maiden Castle, which lies just outside Dorchester in Dorset. Built in about 600 BC, the early phase of the building of this hill fort was a simple and unremarkable site, similar to many other hill forts in Britain, and covering 16 acres. Around 450 BC, it underwent major expansion, during which the enclosed area was nearly tripled in size to 47 acres, making it the largest hill fort in Britain, and by some definitions, the largest in Europe. At some time, Maiden Castle's defences were made more complex with the addition of further ramparts and ditches. Around 100 BC, habitation at the hill fort went into decline and became focused at the eastern end of the site. It was occupied until at least the Roman period, by which time it was in the territory of a Celtic tribe. After the Roman conquest of Britain in the 1st century AD, Maiden Castle appears to have been abandoned. Although Romans may have had a military presence on the site, in the late 4th century AD, a temple and ancillary buildings were constructed within the castle hill fort site. In the 6th century AD, the hilltop was entirely abandoned and was used only for agriculture during the medieval period. Hod Hill is a large hill fort in Blackmoor Vale, 3 miles northwest of Blandford Forum, Dorset. The fort sits on a 143 metre chalk hill of the same name, with a hill fort to the north known as Howelden Hill. The hill fort was inhabited in the late Iron Age period. Radiocarbon dating analysis suggests the date of 500 BC for the main rampart. There is extensive evidence of settlement within the fort, including platforms for roundhouses. The hill was captured in AD 43 by the Roman 2nd Legion, who had already captured Maiden Castle previously seen. 11 iron Bastilla bolts have been found on the hill, clustered in the so-called Chieftain's Hut area. The Romans built a camp in the northeast corner of the original fort seen here, which occupied a mixture of 720 legionaries and auxiliaries. The fort was used as a base for about 5 to 6 years, but passed out of use by about AD 50, when troops were withdrawn for campaigns against Caratacus in Wales, and the remaining men were moved to a new fort further west at Woden Hill. The site was excavated in the 1950s. Today, the hill is an important grassland habitat, home to wildflowers and butterflies, and is in the care of the National Trust. Beacon Hill Hill Fort lies in mid-Hampshire, one of the best-known hill forts in England, and the site of the famous Beacon in Hampshire. The firing of beacons, which were kept on prominent hilltops for many years, an integral part of the defence system of this country, and the last chain of beacons were lit on the 2nd of June 1977 to commemorate the Queen's Silver Jubilee. The fort has never been systematically excavated, but the land and the ditch are sharply defined and well preserved. Within the fortifications is the grave of the 5th Earl of Carnarvon, who played a prominent part in the expedition of the Nile Valley of the Kings, which led to the discovery of Tutankhamun's tomb in 1922, and overlooks Highclere Castle, the ancestral home of the former Lord Carnarvon, today more famously known as Downton Abbey in the TV series. Another hill fort site that was once used as a hilltop beacon was that of the hill fort on top of Herefordshire Beacon, known as British Camp in the Malvern Hills. This scheduled ancient monument is owned and maintained by the Malvern Hills Conservation Trust. The fort is thought to have been first constructed in the 2nd century BC, and the top of the hill was once thought to have been used by the Normans, who built a Mott and Bailey castle type structure. The height of the summit of this hill fort is 1,109 feet. As can be seen, it has very much a commanding view and is quite unique, being built on the contours of the hillside. This very old hillside chalk horse, known as the Uffington White Horse, is situated near the parish of Uffington in the county of Oxfordshire, historically known as Berkshire. The hill forms part of an escarpment of the Berkshire Downs and overlooks the Vale of the White Horse to the north. The site is owned and managed by the National Trust and is a scheduled ancient monument. The figure presumably dates to the later prehistory, i.e. Iron Age or Late Bronze Age period. This view was generally held by scholars even before the 1990s, based on the similarity of the horse's design to comparable figures in Celtic art, and was confirmed following a 1990 excavation led by Simon Palmer and David Miles of the Oxford Archaeological Unit, following which deposits of fine silt removed from the horse's beak were scientifically dated to the Late Bronze Age. Iron Age coins that bear a representation comparable to that of the Uffington White Horse have been found, supporting the early dating of this artifact. Near the Uffington White Horse lies Uffington Castle, an early Iron Age hill fort. Excavations have indicated that it was probably built in the 7th or 8th century BC and continued to be occupied throughout the Iron Age period. Another Iron Age hill fort that lies next to a white horse is that of the Westbury White Horse. The hill fort is known as Bratton Camp. Local records from 1742 suggest that the White Horse was originally cut in the late 1600s, probably to commemorate the Battle of Effendon, thought to have taken place at Bratton Camp in AD 878. Cut into the chalk, the horse originally had to be scored regularly to keep it white. The last recorded scoring took place in 1853. In the late 1950s, the horse was preserved by covering it in white painted concrete. The earthwork defences of the Iron Age fort were constructed over 2,000 years ago. It was a protected settlement containing roundhouses, granaries, stores and workshops. Excavations within the fort in the 18th century revealed quernstones, pottery, Roman and Saxon coins. 3,000 years before, a Neolithic long barrow had been built on this hill. The hill fort was preserved by the later occupants, and excavations into the barrow in the 19th century revealed human skeletons and cremations. The location of this long barrow can just about be seen in this aerial view. This is Old Oswestry Hill Fort, one of the best preserved hill forts in Britain. It was constructed and occupied during the Iron Age. The vast ramparts enclose a roughly diamond-shaped area that may have housed a small settlement. During the Iron Age, Britain was divided into numerous tribal territories, and the hill fort was probably a stronghold and principal settlement for one of these territories. Old Oswestry is a fine example of a multi-fallet or multi-rampart hill fort. It is one of a dense band of hill forts in eastern Wales and the Marches. Much of the information about the site comes from excavations conducted in 1939 by William Varley, and these were not published until recently. The fort seen today was built up over centuries of modification. The two innermost ramparts were the first to be built in the early Iron Age period. This diagram clearly shows how the fort was built up over the centuries. The fort seen today lies just outside the town of Oswestry. It featured on a TV program with Griff Rhys-Jones and also a Radio 4 program about the proposals to build a new housing estate next to this ancient hill fort. The proposed housing estate will be built in the field directly opposite below this aerial shot and will certainly spoil the ambience of this ancient site. Hopefully the proposal will not go ahead. Moving north now to Northumberland and the Scottish borders. There is a great wealth of ancient settlements and hill forts within this area of northern Britain. In the Ingram Valley, Northumberland, lies many ancient settlements on the hills. Neolithic and Bronze Age settlement remains. This is Borough Law, the remnants of a Bronze Age settlement. This hill fort at Castle Hill, Ulnham in Northumberland, of the Iron Age period, with the remains of Romano-British settlement, located in a prominent location at a height of 290 metres. In the College Valley, Northumberland, in the foothills of the Cheviot Hills, lies the remains of Great Heffer, a defended hill fort settlement. The original occupation of the site may predate Roman Iron Age period. Nearby also lies a similar hill fort and settlement, believed to be dating back to about the same period as the previously seen hill fort, the Late Iron Age period. The walls of this hill fort can clearly be seen in the low winter sun, which cannot be seen during the summer months. It has an outer walled enclosure and what looks like a gatehouse entrance, leading to an inner walled enclosure. The remains of an Iron Age housestead or settlement can be seen on the hill opposite. On a hill nearby, just about still in England, on the border with Scotland, lies Ringchester's Hill Fort, a very much well-preserved hill fort, with evidence of remains of hut circles in the centre. About 2 miles away, over the border in Scotland, just outside Kirk Yetholm, lies the hill fort of Green Hambleton. The best preserved Iron Age hill fort of the north is that of Woden Law, lying in the Scottish borders in the Cheviot Hills. It is seen here at its best in the low winter light under a dusting of overnight snow. The ramparts that enclose the summit of Woden Law belong to at least 3 phases of construction of the fort. The innermost rampart surrounds the remains of a number of timber roundhouses. Lie near earthworks on the lower slopes of the hill probably formed parts of an Iron Age field system that were used sometime during the occupation of the fort. Further evidence of prehistoric farming on the flank of the hill is provided by extensive swaths of narrow cultivation ridges. The main Roman road from Northern England into Scotland, known as Dare Street, is located just in the shadow of this fort. Also nearby are the remains of Roman camps. Also in the Scottish borders, not far from Kirk Yetholm, lies this fort and settlement. On an Ordnance Survey map, it is known as the Castles, Fort and Settlement. again seen at its best in these winter conditions. On a hill opposite the previously seen hill fort and settlement lies the remains of yet another hill fort and settlement, seen at its best in the low late autumn winter light. A well-preserved hill fort lies near Harriot, north of Galashiels. Another hill fort and settlement located at Addingston near Lowder. In the middle of this hill fort can clearly be seen the remains of a large hut circle. In South Lanarkshire, in the Upper Clyde Valley, lies the unique Arbory Hill Fort at a height of 429 metres, a mile northeast of Abingdon. It is a well-preserved hill fort which crowns the hill, comprising a walled enclosure and hut circles surrounded by a double rampart. one of the most unusual of the hill forts that remain in the country is that of Old Bewick Hill Fort, located near Wooler in Northumberland. There are two interlocking hill forts with massive earth ramparts. Though little stonework is now in place, there's superb views to the west over the Teal Valley. To the north and the east, the ground turns to High Moor. The more eastern hill fort has two World War II pillboxes built just outside the site. The grassy field to the north has some fine rock art on several large freestanding boulders. Two hill forts known as the Catterfuns lie near the city of Brechin in Angus, Scotland. These Iron Age forts are known as the White Catterfun and the Brown Catterfun. The White Catterfun, seen here, is an oval fort consisting of a massive dry stone wall with a well or cistern in the middle. The light coloured stone wall gives the White Catterfun its name. The dry stone wall of this hill fort, certainly late Iron Age or built in the Pictish period. An interesting hill fort lies south of Perth in Scotland, known as Castle Law, Forgan Denny. It has trench ditches as a result of excavations many years ago. There has also been recent excavations on the site. The Iron Age period was very much a settled period in British history, pre-Roman and Norman invasion, with a milder climate. The people lived on the hillsides in their settlement farming communities, growing crops on the hillsides. But Iron Age man was divided into tribal areas. The hill forts were built for defence and control of the areas over 2,000 years ago. As seen, many of these hill forts lie well preserved in the landscape today and should be protected for future generations to come.